remember he was embarrassed by seeing Carr last month in Mexico City when he had his mask ripped off.
¿Ustedes creen que conocen a un mexicano ese? ¡Eh! ¡Qué equivocados están! Tú y tú, y especialmente tú, conocerán de lo que único es capaz ese.
Again, the attitude from Unica. And this is going to be an interesting matchup. Two men who like to fly high at times.
Let me tell you, Unico can stay on the ground as well. Just look at him. I can see the guy know how to use his hands.
But earlier, you said that Mason Ryan would bring, he'd be the wild card in this matchup on Sunday. You have to think that Unico is also going to be a wild card because we don't know a whole lot about Unico.
Yeah, great point. Ryan for Team Orton, of course. Unico the wild card for Team Barrett.
Quick cover here by Kofi Kingston, shoulders down.
And remember, Unico's arch rival, Sin Cara, is a part of Randy Orton's team. So many rivalries that are really coming to a head in that traditional 10-man Survivor Series elimination matchup.
Check out Kofi.
Oh, man.
That's Unico right there. I mean, the kid is unpredictable. Like you say, we don't know a whole lot about Unico, but tonight we're going to find out.
Well, we do know that Unico possesses an aggressive attitude. You're seeing that on display right now against Kofi Kingston.
Kofi's in trouble.
Former United States champion down. Unico in the cover here.
Again, a toughness that we've seen out of Unico.
Look, Unico right now just riding Kofi Kingston. Got Kingston in a bad, bad way.
And we do know, well, look at this.
Potential submission maneuver here by Unico.
Trying to lock the hands out right there. If he locked those hands out, Kingston's going to be in trouble, dog. He might tap.
One thing we do know about Unico, very proud man. We saw that, the way that he reacted when he lost the mask versus mask.
Oh, Unico down. Whoa. Here. Kofi Kingston in control.
Tell you, Kofi's become a tag team champion. That his confidence has went up. And I'm going to tell you, hadn't been in singles competition like this in a long time.
So Unico here just stalking, kind of showing that attitude off here against Kofi Kingston. Rounding and pounding Kingston. Shoulders down once again. Outside.
Yeah, nice aggressiveness.
Totally impressed with Unico. Like I say, you normally able to scout your opponent. You're normally able to, you know, look at a little footage. But Unico is coming out here tonight with totally the advantage, I believe.
You know, you know Unico's tough as well. He's brought up in Juarez, Mexico, one of the toughest cities in all of Mexico.
Definitely got to be
just
tough.
Across the river from El Paso.
You say, Kofi, huh?
Unico, he's really got Kofi off his game. He hasn't allowed Kofi to really pick up the momentum, and Kofi's at his best when he's flying around the ring.
Yeah, Cole, you mentioned earlier that Unico also likes to take it to the air, but we're seeing a ground and pound attack here by Unico.
Great strategy.
Like I say, this right here is a different Unico. Unico, when he was out here trying to compare with Sin Cara, of course he had to fly to show that he was the better high flyer, but I'm gonna tell you, his ground game is tight.
Check it up now. One, two,
check him
three.
Out.
Work out of the corner. Listen to me. Come on, Kofi.
Punishing Kofi here. Again, Unico with an opportunity Sunday.
Another cover here on Kofi Kingston.
To really shine in the traditional Survivor Series elimination tag team matchup, but really on the grand stage at Madison Square Garden, and the type of match that has really launched careers over the years. I mean, Undertaker made his debut in 1990 in that type of matchup. Rock made his debut winning the sole survivor in 1996. Randy Orton so successful over the years.
Yeah, but you think about all the different combinations you can get.
Whoa, man!
In the Survivor Series elimination match. I mean, it could be down to 5-on-1, 3-on-2, 4-on-2. So many possibilities this Sunday.
Check as Unico
lands on his feet here. Back and forth they go. The pace quickening.
Wow. I'm going to tell you, Kingston needed that one right there to get back into the game. Here he comes.
And again, it's all about the team style at Survivor Series. Kofi Kingston starting to pick up the pace here. And again, Kofi, a member of Team Orton. Again, all about the team winning, not just one individual. At Survivor Series Sunday, bragging rights, so to speak.
The boom drop from Kofi Kingston.
Kofi's feeling it right now. Let's see if he can sustain it and get a victory over Unico tonight.
The boom drop usually sets up Kingston's signature kick. The trouble in paradise. Unico had it well scouted.
tell you, I've been impressed.
Kofi!
Who will build momentum towards Survivor Series? Wow. Kicks the crossbody.
He's got him here. Oh, no. Did he get him? No.
I'm going to tell you, Hunico had both legs locked right there. Should have got a three count. Kofi kicked out right the last second.
I think the referee may have made a mistake. That looked like it was a three count there. I think Unico had Kofi Kingston defeated.
That's it.
So did Unico have a legitimate gripe? He got caught, though, by Kofi Kingston.
Yeah, Unico complaining to the ref, and it cost him.
Here's your winner, one half. WWE Tag Team Champions, Kofi Kingston.
I'll tell you guys, I was impressed. Unico dominated that matchup in my estimation, and I thought he actually picked up the victory. I thought the referee missed the three count there. But Unico protesting cost him.
Let me tell you something. Kofi Kingston went out there, and he earned this victory tonight. You got to give it to him.
Kofi Kingston building momentum towards Survivor Series, and you'd be hard-pressed to argue that this superstar, well, no one can survive his onslaught. The personification of domination, Ezekiel Jackson.
Do not mistake my humility for weakness. Your sinfulness deserves my wrath. There is no peace amongst the presence of my enemies. My opponents fear what they don't understand, then they hate what they cannot conquer. When a man meets a force he cannot destroy, he destroys himself. I am that force. I am Ezekiel Jackson.
Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Orton and Sheamus versus Wade Barrett and Cody Rhodes, a preview of the traditional 10-man tag team match at Survivor Series. Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to happen tonight.
We're back on Friday Night Smackdown here in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Right down the road from the New York City, home of the 25th anniversary of Survivor Series, set to take place this Sunday.
It's actually up the road because it's north of New York. It would be down the road if it was south.
I said down the road from New York City.
Yeah, so that means you'd be going 95 south, not 95 north.
Who cares?
Thanks, north. Columbus.
It would have been funny if you said thanks, Magellan.
Is a Divas GPS. Figure forward fall. Puts in the ring. Natalya, WWE Divas Champion. The clam is on. Beth Phoenix.
And speaking of heading down to New York City, that's what Beth Phoenix will be doing Sunday.
Beth Phoenix will be defending her Divas Championship against Eve. And gentlemen, we found out earlier this week on WWE.com that this match will be a lumberjill match.
Shucky.
Lumberjill match. Man, you know what that means, right? Lumberjill match is just like the lumberjack match, but just different.
I'll explain.
AJ and Caitlin.
The ring Sunday at Survivor Series will be surrounded by the other Divas.
I was
going
to say that I was just laying out to let the next Divas come out. Now let me explain. The Lumberjill match is, like I say, like the Lumberjack match, will be surrounded by all the other Divas. When one of the Divas go out, she will immediately be thrown back into the fire. That's what it's all about, right?
We were introduced to AJ and Caitlin during NXT Season 3. Caitlin won that season. AJ is her spunky BFF. And you'd have to say that the advantage should go to Eve this Sunday because of the fact of the way Beth Phoenix and Natalya have really alienated themselves, guys, from all the other Divas.
I don't agree with that. I think Beth Phoenix is going to handle things on her own. I think Beth Phoenix is the dominant diva in the WWE, and she's going to prove that. Although Caitlin's surprising her here.
Well, I mean, Caitlin's looking good right now.